بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أما بعد، All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and peace be upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I testify that there is no God except Allah Almighty, and I testify that Muhammad is the Prophet and the Messenger of Allah. My brothers and my sisters in Islam, I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us this opportunity, an opportunity for us to get together for the sake of Allah, to remember Allah, to invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these are the gatherings of the rahmah and the mercy of Allah, the gatherings of the maghfirah and the forgiveness of Allah. These are the gatherings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remember us the way we remember Him. And these are the gatherings of the angels, that the angels will record every single name of us, put it on a list, and then show that list to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What more of an honor would you ask for, that your name will be from amongst those people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look at on that list that's been written by the angels of Allah. And tonight, my brothers and my sisters in Islam, we want to address a topic that's connected to our previous topics on Monday nights. And tonight's topic is a topic about ibtila, which means trials and tribulations. Trials and tribulations. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says clearly in the Quran Kareem, هو الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. That Allah Azza wa Jal is the one that had created death, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that created life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that created life that you live, and Allah Azza wa Jal is the one that created the death that you'll die. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that made you exist, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that will make you not exist. هو الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم. So He could test you. So what's the purpose of our life? Why do we live in this world? What's the purpose of living? And what's the purpose of dying? Yes, what's the purpose of dying? ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. So He could trial you. So He could test you to see who are the best of doers from amongst you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created me to test me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created me for what? To test me. Not only for me to enjoy my time in life, not only for me to live this beautiful life, even though the beauty of this life is nowhere compared to the beauty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had created and prepared for us in the hereafter. So why do I exist for here? I exist because of a trial. I exist because of a test. If we understand this, then we will understand many things that will follow it. But where the struggle is that we struggle in understanding that I live in this world for a test. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created me to be tested. To be tested. And that's why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves someone, when Allah azza wa jal loves someone, not necessarily that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him better health and better wealth, but when Allah loves someone, Allah will test him. So the test that we might experience, and I'm sure most of us, either now or in the past, or maybe even in the future, were tested or continue to be tested or will be tested. This test is not necessarily to be what a lot of people perceive it to be, a curse. It's a curse. And some people start uttering with words, is Allah's curse upon me? Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's displeasure upon me? And so on and so on. It's not necessarily to be that. Yes, it can. Some of the tests that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might put someone through, it is a curse from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon them. It is the displeasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon them. But for a believer, it is a pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon them. For a believer, some of the tests that you might experience, some of the tests that you might encounter, it is sometimes a pleasure from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you. When Allah azza wa jalla loves someone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test them. When Allah loves someone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test them. So it's not necessarily that part of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's love that Allah Azza wa Jalla gives you a peaceful life, for example, Allah gives you a lot of wealth, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you good health, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you healthy children, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you a happy marital life.
But sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's test upon you is that Allah tests you with the things that you love most and the ones that you love most to see where is your true love. Is it with Allah or is it with the creation of Allah? Where is the true love? Is it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or is it with the creation of Allah azza wa jalla? Because when you say, Ya Allah, I love you, and Ya Allah, I sincerely love you, and I'll do anything for you and for your love, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts you through the test. It's exactly like that student that studies at school, university, and he says, I studied the subject, I understand the subject, I went through the entire book, then now prove it to us. How are you going to prove it to the teacher? Get tested. It's not enough to claim the love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Ya Allah, I love you and I'll do anything for you. The moment that you claim that love, Allah Azza wa Jalla puts you through the test. Prove it to us. You say you love us, then prove it to us. Let us see what you're really made of. Let us see your true love. And that's what Allah Azza wa Jalla puts you through tests. And most of the times, the tests that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test you are through the things or the ones that you love most, so you could really prove yourself from Allah Azza wa Jalla that you really love Him. And you look through the prophets and the messengers. Our greatest example when it comes to that are the prophets and the messengers. Those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved them, and that are those who truly loved Allah Azza wa Jalla. The prophets and the messengers, without a doubt, and there is no doubt in their love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah Azza wa Jal also loved them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put them through true tests. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put them through severe tests. Now the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself, what does he say? He says alayhi salatu wa salam, that the most tested people and the most trialed people are the prophets and the messengers. And then he says about himself, and I am Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I am the most tested servant and prophet and messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by Allah. And who is Muhammad? Muhammad is the most beloved human being that Allah Azza wa Jalla had ever created. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the closest servant to Allah that ever stepped foot on the face of this earth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than anyone and everyone. And then the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, when Allah loves someone, Allah will test him. And I know most of you do understand this concept. Most of you do understand the principle where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He loves someone, Allah Azza wa Jalla will test them. But we struggle in comprehending this. We struggle in taking it inside. And that's why the first moment that we are struck with a test, we rebel. Some of us, the moment that we are struck with a test, we rebel. We rebel and we start complaining. We start whinging, why? Why, Ya Allah, you are testing me? Why are you testing me with myself? Why are you testing me with my kids? Why are you testing me with my family? I can't handle it anymore. I can't burden this anymore. I can't bear this anymore. Well, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves someone, what does Allah do to him? Allah tests them. You've been striving. You've been struggling in getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until you reach to that point, which is the point of test. Now, you became so close to us, so we are going to test you. There is a point, there are levels. Not everyone is on the same level when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and their relationship with Allah azza wa jal. There are levels that each time you get to those levels, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will start testing you. And the higher levels that you reach to Allah, the greater the test becomes. Because it's all about proving one thing, true love to Allah. True love to Allah. Because claiming love to Allah is the most easiest thing to every single person and the most easiest thing on the tongue. But proving that true love to Allah Azza wa Jal, it is the hardest thing. And the way you prove it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that you give up what you love most, or Allah tests you with what you love most, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees your reaction towards it. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He says in this beautiful hadith that's been narrated by Imam al-Bukhari, he says, مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُصِبْ مِنْهُ. The whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants goodness for. Again, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants what? Goodness, not evilness. Goodness for. Whom Allah azza wa jalla wants benefit for, not harm. So whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants goodness for and benefit for, Allah will test him. Allah will test her. Allah will test them. So at that moment that Allah Azza wa Jalla wants goodness for you, wants a benefit for you, what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do for you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test you. But let me take you a step back. Test you with what? He's not going to test you with something simple. Something that doesn't really mean much to you. Allah will test you with the most beloved thing to you. To shake you up. To see where this heart is going to. What's really in this heart? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed Ibrahim alayhi salam with a child, and it is, that child was the first child to Ibrahim alayhi salam after he had reached over 120 years of age. And you could imagine, years and decades, Ibrahim alayhi salam is waiting for this child until that child comes and arrives. Allah blesses him with the arrival of this child. And you could imagine how connected the heart of Ibrahim alayhi salam was towards his son Ismail. And Ibrahim became so close, so connected, so attached to his first child that he has been waiting for over 100 years. And then the big test comes. What's the big test? Oh Ibrahim, who's more beloved to you? Us or Ismail? Allah or your son? So obviously the typical answer will be, you Allah. And obviously to Ibrahim it's a sincere answer. You Allah. You are the most beloved one to me. You are more beloved to me than my son Ismail. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him through the test. What was the test? Grab your wife, a newly born son, Ismail, and your only son, and your first son that you've been waiting for over 100 years, that you've been so attached to. Grab him and his mother and put him in the middle of a valley that not even an animal can even survive there, not even a plant can even survive there. And Ibrahim did that. Ibrahim did that. And then Ismail alayhi salam grows, and Ibrahim sees signs of righteousness and piety on the face of his son Ismail alayhi salam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts him through another test. Now, not only Ibrahim is connected to him, but extra connected to him to see his son is so righteous and pious. So Allah Azza wa Jalla puts him through another test. Go and slaughter your son. Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put Ibrahim alayhi salam through those different trials and tests? It's all about Ibrahim proving himself to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Ya Allah, you come to me first and everyone else comes second, including my son. For that, Allah Azza wa Jal named Ibrahim and described Ibrahim in the Quran Kareem, wa Ibrahim alladhi waffa. And Ibrahim, the one that fulfilled all Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's obligations upon him. Everything that Allah commanded him to do, he did. Everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him to do, he did. Everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him to do, he did. Even though when it came to sacrifice his own son, his own blood and flesh, he did. But why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command him to do that? Is it because Allah wants to deprive Ibrahim from his son? No. Is it because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to torture Ibrahim? No. It's all about that test that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned. We created you for that test. To see the best of doers. Who is the best of doer amongst you? Who does the righteous actions, the pious actions, the upright actions? Which one of you is willing to obey Allah Azza wa Jal? Follow commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For that, my brother and my sister, you are tested now. And you were tested in the past. And you'll continue to be tested like the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was tested. And he says about himself, and I am the most tested servant of Allah and prophet of Allah from the rest of the servants of Allah and the prophets of Allah. He, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That once Aisha asked the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after the battle of Uhud, where the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was attacked and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was surrounded by the people of Quraysh that wanted to kill the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and get rid of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam to get rid of Islam. And Aisha heard of the encounter of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the people of Quraysh in the battle of Uhud. And she heard what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam experienced and what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam endured. So she tells him, "Oh Messenger of Allah, did you ever experience a day that's more harsh upon you, that's more worse upon you than the day of Uhud?" Aisha thought about it. What day, what moment was it the worst and the most difficult moment upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And she said, "Oh Messenger of Allah, did you ever experience a day that's more harsh and that's more difficult upon you than the day of Uhud?" And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Yes, I experienced worse days. I've experienced harsher days. I experienced the days when I went to At-Ta'if, calling the people of At-Ta'if to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So their response to me was abusing me, physically attacking the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, insulting the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, assaulting the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, stoning Muhammad alayhi salatu wa sallam. Yes, Muhammad alayhi salatu wa sallam, your prophet and messenger, the greatest human being ever to step foot on the face of this earth. He was insulted, he was abused, he was sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stoned, he was sworn at sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All this because he called him to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam. That's a test. That's a test. And it really hurt the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was insulted and assaulted and offended alayhi salatu wa sallam. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was stoned alayhi salatu wa sallam. Rocks and stones were thrown at him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because why? Because he was trying to save him. He was trying to save them from the sadness of this world to the happiness of Islam. From the hellfire to the paradise. That's why sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was hurt. And he says to Aisha, "Yes, I did experience a day that's worse than the day of Uhud." But that's 2 days, the day of Ta'if than the day of Uhud. But there are a lot more days that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did experience. There are a lot more days that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam encountered, which are days of difficulties and days of challenges and days of trials and tribulations, days of tests, days of calamities that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself experienced. So where do we put ourselves to that? Where do we compare ourselves to that? Where's our position? Because the moment that we are struck with a very simple test, we collapse. We turn our backs to Allah Azza wa Jal. We can't handle it anymore. That's too much on me. The moment I face or experience or encounter a challenge in my life, I straight away collapse. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He makes it very clear in the Quran al-Kareem, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. Do people think, Allah is saying that to you. Allah Azza wa Jal is saying that to you. Do you think that you'll be left alone to say, "I'm a believer," without you being tested? Allah Azza wa Jal is asking you. And it's not a question that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking for an answer, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking a rhetorical question here to affirm and confirm an answer where Allah is saying and asking and saying to you, do you think for that 1 second in your life that you're just going to get up and say, "Ya Rab, I'm a believer. I'm a lover of yours. I'm a mu'min. I'll do anything for you, Allah. I'll die for Islam. I'll sacrifice for Islam. I'll give up everything for Islam." Allah is saying to you, do you think we're just going to let you say that before we test you? Before you even prove yourself to us? You think you're just going to be let to go to do whatever you want? You think just easy for you to say, Ya Allah, I love you. Ya Allah, I'm a believer. Ya Allah, I'll do anything for you. I'll sacrifice anything for you. I'll give up anything for you. Allah's saying to you, do you think we're just going to heed that by words? Let us see what you're made of. So Allah Azza wa says, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يَفْتَنُونَ. Do people think they'll be left alone to say that we are believers before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala truly tests them? Before you are really tested? You think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just going to let you go and say, I'm a believer. And Allah doesn't test you. Okay, you're a believer. Show us. Prove yourself. Okay, Ya Rab, I'm willing to show you. I love you, I love you, I love you. No, no, no. Say, I love you from now to the day of judgment. What does that mean? Prove it. How? We're going to test you. We'll put you through the exam. We'll put you through the test. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla continues to say that we tested the ones before you. فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will filter. Allah Azza wa Jalla will filter the truthful ones from the untruthful ones. Allah will filter them. There are a lot of those people who claim the love of Allah Azza wa Jalla. There are a lot of those who say, Ya Rab, we love you, but that love comes with a consequence. And the consequence is that you must face the trials. It comes with a package. It's not only by the tongue, it's by the sacrifice. For that, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلَّهُ خَيْرٌ إِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ سَرَّاءَ شَكَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءَ صَبَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ وَمَا ذَلِكَ إِلَّا لِلْمُؤْمِنِ. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he says, amazing to the believer. Amazing to the believer. النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام himself, he is amazed from the believer. Amazing to the believer. All his matters, all her matters are good for them. If something good comes to them, Allah blesses them with something, the first thing a believer does, he thanks Allah Azza wa Jal. He is grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, appreciative of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given him, because he knows that this blessing came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The moment Allah Azza wa Jal gives them something, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestows something upon them which is good, a grace, a ni'mah, a bounty, a gift, they thank Allah for it because they know that this came from Allah. But then the other part of the hadith, what does the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءَ صَبَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. And when a harmful matter befalls him, he has patience for the sake of Allah. He knows that's the test. That's the trial. Allah is testing you, and Allah is testing me, and therefore, I'm going to stand strong to continue enduring this test. I'm going to continue facing this test. I'm going to continue making sure that I pass this test. I pass the exam. I'm not going to fall. I'm not going to collapse. I'm going to continue facing this test. For that, my brother and my sister, it is so important for us always to ponder and contemplate that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will continue testing me. And when Allah tests you, He tests you not because He hates you, not because He wants to punish you, not because He wants to send a curse upon you, which in some cases it can be, but not to the believer. It is a gift of Allah upon you. So now, I need to come out from this mind frame that the test that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests me is a test not because Allah Azza wa Jal wants to torture me or Allah wants to deprive me, because Allah loves you. So I need to change my perception. What a test to me. A test to me is a gift. Yes, I know and understand that it's very hard to swallow and to contemplate. But the truth is, a test from Allah upon a believer is a gift of Allah upon a believer. That's how your perception needs to change. That's how I need to perceive a test in my life. That whenever Allah Azza wa Jal tests me, that's a gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon me. Why? Because it is a promotion. Allah's promoting you. Allah's elevating you. So don't cry over it. but be happy. And the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum understood this. They understood this. They acknowledged it. They contemplated it. They accepted it. And that's why whenever they were tested, they used to say, we'll welcome Allah's promotion upon us. Not Allah's test. We welcome Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's promotion upon us. I'm being tested now. Not because I've done anything wrong. Not because I committed an evil action. Because I love Allah. I've reached to that point, to that level and that point where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is now is testing me. So now I thank Allah for promoting me. Which one of us these days thinks of test as a promotion? Most of us think of a test, especially a test from Allah, as a curse. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's wrath. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's displeasure upon us. But the true mu'min looks at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's test as a promotion, a blessing. Subhanallah. The difference between those who have true iman and those who have weak iman. Those who have true iman, they only get closer and closer to Allah Azza wa Jalla with the more tests Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests them. They look forward. They look forward to those tests. Which one of us looks forward to a test? On the contrary, we're so upset and we're so scared and sometimes we're so terrified of a test. But know the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He loves you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests you. That's the only way. There is no other way. There's no shortcuts. There's no cutting corners. Your only way to Allah and getting closer to Allah is to be tested. There's no other way. You're not going to get a voucher and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to say, okay, now we promote you just because you received that voucher. You're not going to do anything special and you're just going to get that promotion. You want to be promoted? You must be tested. That's it. That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's way. There's no other way. And if there's anyone that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have promoted because of their good deeds and actions, would have been the prophets and messengers in the front line, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continued to test every single one of them. And more, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because the only way to get closer to Allah is to be tested. And here we are. Ya Allah, get me closer to you. The moment Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests us, we collapse. You are the one that asked for that promotion. You are the one that asked Allah Azza wa Jalla to get close to Him. So the moment Allah Azza wa Jalla opens that door for you to be promoted, you turn your back on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because you cannot bear or handle the test. Isn't that what you want? Allah will test you. You want Allah to promote you? You'll be tested. You want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to elevate your position? Allah Azza wa Jalla is going to test you. You want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to love you more? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to test you. You want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you the Jannah? You are going to be tested. You want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase your hasanat? You are going to be tested. You want to feel that close relationship with Allah Azza wa Jal? You are going to be tested and you will continue to be tested. This is Allah's way. So you need to prepare yourself and ready yourself for the test. That the moment you are struck with that test, you are ready. And not to react negatively, but react positively. Like the old woman that lost her son, and while she was weeping and crying over the death of his son, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came near her, and the Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam told her, don't cry and have patience. So she says, ilayka anni, leave me alone. He doesn't even know what I just encountered. He doesn't even know what I just experienced. So the Sahaba saw the reaction of this woman towards the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and her herself, she was a Sahabiya, a female companion. So they approached her and they told her, you know what, you were just rude to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How dare you speak like that to the Prophet alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? She didn't even know it was the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that spoke to her earlier. So she ran to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, seeking the forgiveness of the Prophet alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and apologizing to him. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with his soft heart and merciful character sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, accepted her apology, and then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught her something. A very important lesson to her and an important lesson to us. In Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, إِنَّمَا الصَّبْرُ عِنْدَ الصَّدْمَةِ الْأُولَى. That patience is at the very beginning of the calamity. Patience is that at the very beginning of the calamity, at the very beginning of the test. You want to be patient and you want to pass the exam, then you need to pass the exam from the very beginning of the exam, not at the end of the exam. So don't expect to get 10% out of the entire mark of the exam and say, you know what, I'm going to pass. No. You need to react positively from the very beginning, not at the end. Not from the very beginning when you are struck with that test, you are struck with that calamity and that trial, you react, you scream, you shout, you do this, you do that, then inshallah sabr. No. Innama sabr inda sadmat al-ula. Patience and reacting towards a test and a calamity comes at the very beginning of the test, not at the end. And that's inshallah will be our topic inshallah next week bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. That ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us from amongst those who listen and hear and act upon what they listen and hear. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bestow His blessings upon us and to give us strength in handling the tests and calamities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put us through. I ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to accept from us and not to reject us. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst those who are strong when they are struck with any calamity, any test, any trial. Ameen. Rabbil Alameen. Subhanakallah bihamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.